during the Labor Day holiday. You have an event coming up, right? Would you like to elaborate on that?
Labor Day Saturday, August 30th, that's coming up this Saturday. We're going to do a one-day event at Reseda Park. We're going to have a good time. We got all the ball players there. We got the music there. We got the rappers, the singers. We got 10 and under teams are going to be playing, 12 and under, 15 and under, 18 and under, girls and boys. And we're going to have the a pro division. We're also going to have the street ball celebrities. And so we're going to have a ball out there on Saturday all day long. We're putting up the bleachers. We got the mic up. We're going to be doing play-by-play. We're going to have a good time. So we're welcoming everybody to come out and bring the kids out, because they're going to be getting autographs and see some good ball playing and some tricks, behind-the-back passes, some slam dunks, going to the top of the backboard. So we're going to have a whole crew there. We're going to have a ball this Saturday for Cedar Park.
Excellent.
We're also bringing some of the schools out, some of the local colleges, to come out and offer information about, you know, their education system.
Oh, yeah.
Along with some of the health services, and we got information for employment. So there's going to be definitely options out there for everybody to, you know, check out. And then we're going to be putting together videos and stuff for it, see the highlights and everything on the websites, and, you know, keep it going.
Most importantly, this is a free event, you know, so everyone in the community is welcome to come. You know, right now with the economy, you know, prices are up. So a lot of, you know, people are looking for something free to do during Labor Day weekend. So like he said, it was August 30th. So make sure, you know, everyone, you know, should come out.
Exactly. At Reseda Park. Very good. For what time?
Well, we're going to start at 9 o'clock and go all the way to about 6 o'clock that evening. But the main thing we were going to do it also at halftime, we're going to have speakers come out and give information about employment, health service, and education. And if they know gang members, they need to provide that information to them. We're going to have numbers so they can give to them, because a lot of gang members possibly won't be coming. They're very territorial, so they might not be coming out there. But we all know people that's probably involved in gangs or at risk, and we want to provide them with those kind of services and referrals that they can possibly, if they know somebody, to get a job, health services for the family, or even educational grants and scholarships. Right. We're going to be giving them for an option that they will possibly cut down and reduce gang violence and crime.
Right. So the information from that, somebody can pass along word of mouth, and they'll still get the information anyway.
Yes, we got handouts we're going to be giving them with numbers on it they can call and get the help that they need.
You know what? I'm tired of the fighting. I'm tired of the bullets. I'm tired of the violence. If somebody approached you and said, you know, we want to check this out, we want to participate.
Well, when we were doing the program, we had a lot of gang members play. This that first time meeting peace officers, highway patrol, deputy sheriffs, LAPD, probation officers, parole agents. They said, wow, these guys are all right. You know, maybe we need to have an alternative. We're having fun with these guys. All we used to do is see them as locking up mom and dad or brother and sister. Hey, these guys are regular people also.
Right.
We came from some of these communities. We just want to give back and say, listen, we'll help you get an alternative to gang violence and also crime. We're all in this together.
Right. So when they all came to the park and everybody's playing, they're really just themselves. They're not playing a role.
Absolutely.
They're not
having
a cop,
fun.
They're not a gangster. They're not a whatever. No,
absolutely. Right.
It's so-and-so playing ball with somebody else and having a good time.
That's what it's all about.
That's it. Ryan, if somebody said to you, I want to join your crew, what would you look for?
Anytime somebody wants to come forward and join, I'm always open arms, because whatever they can bring to the table is something that we didn't have before they came to the table. So I would say, whether it's you want to play basketball, you want to do some music, you want to draw, you want to sing, whatever you can possibly do, it's something that we didn't have previously.
Exactly. Ken, when you put the program together, when you founded the program, what were you looking for?
Well, anytime we put together a program, we have it open for anybody that's interested in the mission. The mission at this point is peace in the streets and silence to the violence.
Right.
So even though a person might not be a member of a crew, they might be doing stuff in their home by making calls and trying to get some help as far as financially is concerned. Everybody has a passion for something, and it can help out for the main goal is peace in the streets and silence to the violence. Everybody wants to walk down the street without fearing getting killed, with a grandmom and grandpa want to take a walk in the evening time without fearing they might get jumped or hurt. Baby girl and baby boy, or brothers and sisters, 4 and 5 years old, they want to be able to go to the park and not be, you know, kind of scared when they hear gunshots and things like that. So I think that's an international goal, silence to the violence and peace in the streets.